Today, we are seeing Pfizer shares lead the Dow right now up by about 4.25% after the news came that the U.S. government would be adding $2 billion to that company's efforts, as well as BioNTech, its partner here, coming from the Health and Human Services, I should say here. $2 billion, that would be the largest the U.S. so far has invested to secure COVID-19 vaccine supplies, though we have seen it invest in other biotech companies as well. For the $2 billion, the Department of Health and Human Services and the Defense Department is lining itself up to receive 1 million doses of the vaccine if it gets clearance, and could potentially ask for an additional 500 million doses as well. BioNTech, that partner there with Pfizer, we've seen shares there rise by about 75% in just 1 month. So how should investors be thinking about the latest news? Here to join us for more on that is Jared Holz, healthcare equity strategist at Jefferies. And Jared, obviously, we've seen a few bets being made, not just Pfizer and BioNTech, also AstraZeneca. We'll get into that in a second. But what do you make of the latest move here? $2 billion, a lot of money.
It's a lot of money for sure. It's the second or third time we've seen a big capital infusion from the government straight into the pockets of these pharmaceutical and biotech companies. We saw Novavax a couple of weeks ago at $1.6 billion. Today, nearly $2 billion. For the first 100 million doses, which will satisfy roughly 50 million patients, depending on how the dose regimen works. But this is, very indicative of what we've been seeing and sort of a sign of the times with respect to how the government is interplaying with the industry.
Yeah, and when we think about how it's interplaying with the industry, I just want to bring up the scorecard here, since we've seen it making its bets. $1.2 billion into AstraZeneca for 300 million doses. Their research coming out of the University of Oxford. They also invested $1.6 billion in an agreement with Novavax, which a lot of people were quick to point out that company has never successfully brought a vaccine to market. And now we have this Pfizer and BioNTech bet. So clearly, there's a lot going on here. But I guess the question is, should investors be placing their bets similarly in kind, or are there risks that you would want to stress because there's no guarantee that any of these actually get to market?
Yeah, they're all very risky. We really haven't seen any real life evidence that any of the vaccine programs work against the virus itself. So the three phase one studies that have been very well documented over the past couple of weeks, the Pfizer study, the Oxford Astra study, and the Moderna study are all very limited in terms of the patient populations that they've been serving. The virus has not been exposed, or the patients rather have not been exposed to the virus. All we've seen is the vaccine creates either antibodies that are, at a level that is getting, the street or clinicians excited, or T cells are being activated to such an extent that the same response is being had. But we have no idea in a real world phase three setting with 30,000 patients in each trial, at least, how these vaccines are going to work. So my view is there's been a ridiculous amount of speculation around the success of these trials. And the bets, I believe, are going to be a little bit more difficult with the success of the stock valuations year to date.
Yeah, and when we talk about stock valuations year to date, Novavax, one of those lesser known names, I guess, up 3,000% year to date. As I said, BioNTech, also one of those, I guess, smaller names there, up 75% in just the last month. So when we look at these, are they trading to perfection? Is it right now the market kind of pricing in that one of these candidates, if not all of them, would eventually result in a vaccine that is as successful as we're describing here?
Yeah, certainly. I think most of the stocks have gotten their fair credit or their fair share of the credit for successful vaccine development and commercialization. So from here on out, it's really going to come down to who has the best data, whether investors are looking at this as a winner-take-all market, whether it's going to be seen as multiple winners can participate. But when we look at the amount of vaccine support that's been given to these companies, as we were discussing before, from a dollar standpoint, and then look at how many patients can be treated with that, we've already sort of come up with a sum that equals the amount of the American population. So I'm just not sure exactly what the upside is, but we've been saying for weeks now that these stocks are trading much more on the narrative than they are on actual valuation. So I think pairing that or trying to find the disparity between the narrative and the fundamental story is the most challenging part.
Yeah, and two questions too to wrap up here on that front. Despite all that that we're hearing that you're saying right now, you still have the view that at least one vaccine would be approved before the election. So, I mean, that's kind of the timeline you seem to be operating with. And then on top of that, we have heard too that a lot of these companies might forego charging for the vaccines, even though they're getting this money from the U.S. government. So, I mean, how does that kind of play out in how investors should be thinking about that upside as well?
Yeah, so I think, you know, the first question is yes. I'm standing by the call that we will have at least one vaccine program approved by the election. It just seems that the administration is so focused on driving the value of the stock market up. And to me, that might be the biggest element of this entire conversation when it comes to timing of an approval, whether we have the phase three interim data and it looks good enough to approve. I really think the bar that has been established is quite low and will continue to be addressed by the government in terms of this warp speed that we've been hearing time and time again as far as the progress or the acceleration with development. But it remains to be seen whether that's actually going to happen. A lot's going to be predicated on the data itself.
Yeah, and as we've always kind of highlighted here in the biotech space, buyer beware when we think about what could happen if the data does not live up to the expectations. And a good warning there from Jared Holz, healthcare equity strategist at Jefferies. Appreciate you taking the time to chat.
You bet. Thank you.